We'll see about that. There are a lot of very competitive footballers on the field today.
There certainly are, Clive, and I'm really looking forward to this one. It is an opportunity for those guys to really lay down a benchmark to the manager and show them what they can do and show them that they are capable of playing top-class international football.
Stadio Olimpico has special resonance for fans of Liverpool Football Club. This is where they won the European Cup for the first time in 1977, and it's where they beat the home club, Roma, to become European champions again 7 years later.
Some of these big stadiums, Clive, don't always have the greatest atmosphere, but this isn't one of them. This will be throbbing in here today.
Referee for this one is Scott McBeany. Italy get this match underway. Ball played down the wing. Sharp passing. Not short of support. Can they get to it? Atkinson. Great vision that, one wing to the other. Beautifully done. Here's a chance. Cleared the danger. Referee has given the throw-in to the Italians. Ref signal for another throw. It's going to be another throw. The ball has got plenty of support. Will he find a man? Got his head on the ball. Quarter won by Italy. want to take advantage of this if they can. Goalkeeper will take those all day long. Important to retain possession. That's a fine tackle. The ball do the work. Italy keeping the ball well and using it well too. Oh, he almost hit it too well.
Well, that just gives the goalkeeper something to think about. He now knows that whenever this guy gets a chance, he'll have a shot.
The referee has indicated the time he wants added on. Can't be losing the ball there. They can counter-attack now. Half-time, and all a bit tame and tepid, really. Not sure we expected much from a friendly, but it's goalless.
Yeah, no real tempo to the game so far. Maybe a change or two might change that.
We're underway again, Ireland kick-off. It's a game that's almost impossible to predict. Header goes wide. Oh. moving the ball around well. The Republic of Ireland are a good passing team when they find their rhythm.
Not a good cross. No problem for the defence.
They're on the ball again.
Delivers it in.
Cross, no problem for the goalkeeper. Here, change of emphasis maybe. It'll be interesting to see where the substitute plays. Support here, can he? Keeping, can they get to it though?
Referee has given the throw to Italy. Italy are going to use the substitute here.
Wide of the target with a header.
Using the full width of the field here.
Gives it and gets it back. A little bit of pressure building, Republic of Ireland asking questions. Can he get to it? With his head?
Oh, what a goal! What a perfectly directed header. He's so good at that. You would struggle to say which of these teams are supposed to be the odds-on favourites and which are the rank outsiders. The goal's turned the match on his head.
Hey, next goal, Clive, is massive for the underdogs. They're in front now. Can they hang on to it?
That's a great leap and a very good finish with his head.
It's a tight match, this one, but Ireland are in front. Tries a shot! That is just so frustrating.
Well, that's another opportunity missed, and if they are going to get back into this game, they're going to have to do it very soon, Clive. The clock is running down now.
We've reached that stage in the game when tiredness can become a factor, and I think the manager's just trying to address that before it's a problem. Doesn't want to change too much, though. Intercepted that, saw the danger, dealt with it. Now the board with the added minutes is about to go up. It's three extra minutes. Possibilities here. Oh no, what a chance to equalise. That could have gone right back into it. Internationals can drift and disappoint, but that one was competitive throughout. Could have gone either way.
Yeah, both teams were going for it, weren't they? There was a good edge to this one.